Just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now let's head down to the coin toss. It is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Harley has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep to open up the ball game. Here we go, folks. Taken at the five. Ball is loose. Fumble. It's scooped up, and he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. They nearly gave that ball away.
But luckily, that guy was paying attention to what was going on and was able to recover the football.
First and 10. Ball on their own 27. He's hit and taken down.
When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want it.
That's a great tackle. The 33-yard line.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
It's second down and a long way to go. Ball on their own 33.
91 is the mic.
And he can't get away from the pressure.
That's a loss of 7 yards. Third down.
Time the big fella got home and came up with a sack, but credit the call by the defensive coordinator there with the blitz. The offensive linemen were occupied with those linebackers, and it freed up the defensive lineman to make that sack.
Fourth and long here after the sack. Davidson is the punter. He gets it away. This is a really nice punt. Brown fields it at the 35. Whoa, he just took a licking. The Eagles and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing well.
Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football. Other times they're going to try to air it out. And when you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job as an offensive staff of putting together a good plan. And I'm sure we're going to see it again today.
It's second down, 8 to go. Ball on the 49-yard line. He's got an opening. Gains his way to the 40-yard line.
Yeah, I love this offensive coordinator. I've always really appreciated his approach to the game. He's a little bit unorthodox in his approach, and this time he gives the wide receiver a chance to carry the football to pick up a first down.
After a decent run up the gut.
Gain of 5 yards. That brings up second and five.
It's second and five here. Ball on the 35-yard line. Fires out to his receiver. He's taken down at about the 27-yard line. The Falcons lost one of their key guys earlier to that injury, and unfortunately, I don't think he's going to play any more football today. Got some open field. Nice gain as he works the right side.
6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. On the run. And they make the stop at the 20.
Gain of 1 yard. That makes it third and three.
Right.
decent pickup.
That's a gain of 7 on the play.
From the 13-yard line, it's first down. They come out in an empty backfield. And they'll score. Spectacular run by the quarterback.
That is such a weapon for your offense. When you have a quarterback who can do things like that, the coach probably loves drawing up plays for this guy.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. So that's an 8-play, 53-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. It can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Eagles are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
This offense lost the ball by way of a fumble the last time they had it.
Well, they're already playing from behind the eight ball, but they have plenty of time to get back in this thing.
And they got it. So the sack makes this a second and long. And he throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
They go with a run, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss.
That makes it fourth and long.
Davidson to punt. And this one is a beauty. Brown takes it at the 33. And down he goes at the 48-yard line.
In turn for a gain of 15 yards.
So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
And he's tackled at the 18. Perfectly run option keeper.
Not what you'd expect when you prepare all week to defend the option. But then again, give this offense some credit. These guys aren't exactly the scout team.
First and 10 following that big run. And now he's got room to run. Tackle made around the 8-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. That makes it first and goal.
Down. And that's his second touchdown of the day.
Yeah, he has a lot of freedom to make plays like that, and he can do it because of his athletic ability. The coaches recognize that, and it's proven to be successful.
He makes the PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles are smothering the opposition so far today. What's this offense got to do to get off the schneid?
Well, you've talked to offensive coordinators about that, and they'll say we've got to find our go-to guy. Who are our players that we know we can count on, and what are the plays that we typically feel the most confident about? That's usually where the offenses tend to go when they're getting shut down.
Gains his way to the 33-yard line.
Second and 2.
91 is the mic.
Number 98 with the carry. Call it a gain of 2 yards. That'll bring up 3rd and inches.
at midfield. Gains his way to the 46-yard line. A nice third down conversion there.
This offense has a tendency to run the football in this situation, as you can see, with good reason.
Has some daylight. Nice run, and he's brought down. Around 5 yards there on the option keep. Gets it. He's in space. He's pushed out of bounds.
Around the 30-yard line.
And he carries the ball for a nice game. From the 24-yard line, second down. And down he goes at the 16-yard line. That's it for one, and we might have the upset of the week on our hands. 14-0, Eagles. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. They go to the left for a nice game.
That's a game of 6 on the 4. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
Touchdown, Falcons.
This guy seems to make things happen no matter what kind of space he has to work with. All he needs is a little crease of daylight and forget about it.
And he adds the extra point. Bowling Green gets set to kick this one away. He just drills this one. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
Tackle right around the 22-yard line.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking scheme. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
From their own 22-yard line. Second down. They'll bring him down right around the 26-yard line.
That'll make it 39.
Quick pass. Inside the 30. He's tackled at the 18-yard line.
It's really difficult to cover somebody this fast. You can't stay with him in one-on-one coverage. And even when you double-team him, he still has the speed to beat you. You just have to hope that the timing is off between him and his quarterback.
Now it's 1st and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. Gets out to around the 9.
Gain of 9 on the play. That brings up 2nd and 1.
Roger, Roger! Check right 27, check right 27. Here we go.
Throw's complete, he's got room to work. Touchdown! And did that play ever develop nicely?
Well, it's all
all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
Boy, that was an easy throw for the quarterback. Had to be a mistake of some kind or miscommunication by the defense in that secondary, but the quarterback finds his receiver wide open for the touchdown.
And he converts the extra point. Harley, ready to kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. They'll spread the field with five wide. And they got him.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on the quarterback. It would be interesting to see how he responds from this hit and whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges them to start playing a little bit better.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation.
91 is the mic.
Give to the tailback, and he's met in the backfield. 2-yard loss for the halfback.
That'll bring up 39.
Hit on the throw, he caught it, and he's taken down at about the 17-yard line. That play was designed to pick up a first down, but they didn't do it.
It looks like the receiver just lost track of where he was on the field.
Davidson awaits the snap. Oh, excellent punt. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line.
Returned for a gain of 12 yards.
A touchdown was the end result of their last drive, as this offense moved the ball very well with their passing game.
I think this defense has got to do something, because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
From the 42-yard line, first down. Brought down at the 40-yard line.
Gain of 2 on the play. That brings up 2nd and 9.
Man left, man left. Four down.
Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 32. He gets sacked on the play.
That brings up 4th and 15.
He'll try to change the field position and especially not get it to the end zone. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20.
Boy, aren't they? They're so full of energy. It's almost scary.
This aggressive defense has enjoyed multiple sacks tonight. This offense hasn't had any trouble moving the ball on the ground.
Well, they are running it pretty well, so that wouldn't be a bad thing. You take the yards however you can get them.
All the good plays from this defense has helped them into the lead. The defense really shut these guys down the last time they had the ball. Run there as they work the outside.
Called a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
Gets it out. He's met immediately.
Loss of 4 yards. That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
Third down, 8 yards to go.
Ball on the 22-yard line. Throws it to the outside. And that's his receiver who's wide open. And he's finally shoved out at the 22. It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. And he shoved out of bounds at the 7.
Linebacker who was right there to make the play.
From the 7-yard line, it's second down.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That makes it 31.
91 is the mic.
And he is drilled at the 6-yard line.
I don't really know what this one's for. Let's find out.
Holding offense.
You've got to work so hard to defend your quarterback when you're backed up like this. But once you commit that hold, you might as well have given up the sack.
Well, it's third and goal, and they're 10 yards out. And they'll get him in the backfield. Loss of 5 there.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
Kicks up, and he got it. Tate has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Eagles are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
The offense is looking to be a little bit more successful with this drive as they had to punt the ball away the last time they had it. He's taken down at about the 37-yard line.
A good quarterback knows when and how to improvise. And if he's got the skills, he can also turn a scramble into something big.
He's going to try and scramble. And he's going to come up with a sack.
The Eagles call a timeout. That's their second of the half. Second down and 12.
Ball on their own 35. He's on the run. And they make the stop around the 45-yard line.
Call it a gain of 10 yards. That'll bring up 32.
Caught, and he's hit immediately. Bowling Green's going to have to use their second time out of the half.
He punt. No, he faked it. Tackle made at the 44-yard line.
That's a gain of 10 on the play.
Check, check.
First down.
Regular. Kill.
Strike. right to his receiver. No good. First half is over, and this is why they play the game. 21-10, Eagles.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Rhys Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. There is nothing, and I mean nothing, that is more important than turnovers. Now, so far, neither defense has been able to force one in this game, but you never know when that opportunity is going to come up.
No, and people look at turnovers and they assume that it's luck a lot of times, but a lot of times it's preparation. It's being able to know that when certain teams line up, like South Carolina back in 2002, in a certain formation where it's Tucson open stud, and they got three receivers to my side, and I know it's a rollout pass. As a defensive end, I widened my stance a little bit, came upfield, hit the quarterback as he was throwing it. Next thing you know, the ref signals his hands up in the air, and you get 6 points for it. So you can definitely be prepared, and that's how you force those turnovers.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Rhys Davis.
Want, need. Got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
All right, Rhys and Davis, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Made around the 19-yard line.
There are a lot of players in the college game that can make something happen when the blocking breaks down. But when it's that bad, I don't care who you are, you're going down for a loss.
Second down at 16 to go. Ball on the 19. Here's an opening. And he's tackled right around the 30.
That's a gain of 11 on the play. That'll make it 35.
Now he's scrambling. And down he goes at the 35. He really got a hold of that one. And he's taken down at the 30-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He's scrambling. And he's going to be sacked for a loss. Complete, brought down, nothing doing.
Sack ends him down at the 30-yard line. That brings up 3rd and 10.
Here's the halfback on the screen. Tackle around the 44-yard line. Gets to about the 47-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
He throws left. That close to being intercepted.
This just shows you that you don't need to be sacking the quarterback to disrupt the passing game.
3rd down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. Runs it right. Nice pickup.
That's good brings up fourth and three.
Let's see if he aims for the sideline and tries to get this thing down deep in their own territory. It's away, and it's a booming punt. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The defense shut him down on their last drive, forcing a quick punt. They try the right side. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That's a gain of six on the play. That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Throws this one out to the left. It falls incomplete.
Williams was the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up third and four.
Tries to pitch it, and now the ball is loose. Got an opening for the 10. He's all the way home. Touchdown.
It always makes you nervous anytime a defender tries to pick up a fumble and run with it instead of just falling on it. Man, did it work out for him here for a big-time play in the score.
And he hits the PAT. Bowling Green gets set to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Eagles fans have got to be going crazy. It looked like they had this one in hand or could put it out of reach, and they haven't been able to do it.
This is a tough game for the fans to watch because their team was so dominant early in the game, and now they've just gone cold, and they've allowed the opponent to get right back into this game. They better find something here to be able to try to get out of here with a win.
Here's a handoff, left side. He makes it to the 25-yard line.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. Over the middle to his tailback. They'll bring him down at about the 35.
Number 9 makes the tackle at the 35-yard line. That'll bring up third and inches.
And he carries the ball for a nice game.
Gain of 6 yards. First down.
From their own 41-yard line, it's first down. He's at midfield. He's at the 40. At the 30. For the 20. The 10. And a huge touchdown play. He's having quite a game. 3 rushing touchdowns now.
And the defense has to be steaming right now. How do you let the same guy score 3 times on you?
And he converts the extra point. A 4-play, 75-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot, and they also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And he tackles them hard at the 16.
That was a loss of 9 on the play. That'll make it second and long.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long.
91 is the mic.
Zips it to the back. Knocked out of bounds at the 23.
39-yard line.
Nice throw to hit the out route against man coverage for a first down.
Gets it to his wide receiver, and he's got another one. He's tackled at the 36-yard line. They go to the ground game. Tackled after a decent pickup. 7 yards there on that bit of misdirection.
That makes it second and two.
Fires quickly and he's got his man. And he's immediately tackled. Quick to an open man, he dropped it.
Number 17 was the intended receiver.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 19. And he makes it out to about the 17-yard line. They get nice yardage on that run. And he picked up almost four on that halfback delay. They're going to go for the easy three here. And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. There was some movement on the line.
False start, offense.
Just a mental lapse, but it's going to cost them 5 yards.
Still fourth down.
It's up, and it's good. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
It's early in this game, so the defense can still have an opportunity to make some adjustments. But if things don't turn around in a hurry, it's really going to start to affect the psyche of that defensive line.
He's got an opening. Brought down at the 42. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 42. Makes it to the 44. 1 quarter to go, and this looks like it could come down to the very end. 28-20, Eagles. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. They'll knock him down for a loss. From the 46-yard line, second down. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. And he is drilled at the 38-yard line.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 4.
He's taken down at about the 27-yard line.
You don't always need to throw the ball with a lot of zip, although it does help in some cases. When you have accuracy like this guy, you can make all the throws.
Now he tries to buy some time. And they make the stop at the 18.
That brings up 2nd and 1.
It's 2nd down now, and they're just a few feet away from that 1st down marker. scrambling around. The 10. And that sets them up with a first and goal. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Tackle made at the 3.
That brings up second and goal.
Second down and goal. Ball on the 3-yard line. And he's in the end zone. Touchdown. That is his 4th touchdown on the ground. And this has been quite a game for him.
This guy's been so good today. This quarterback has so much athletic ability, and he's been one step ahead of the defense all game long.
And he tacks on the extra point.
That's what I'm talking about, baby.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Well, the defense held him to 3 on their last possession. Pitching a shutout on this drive would be even better. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
Accuracy is such a vital part of being a quarterback. You've got to have an ability to lay the ball right into your guy's hands.
So it's 3rd down now, and they're going to need about 4. Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. That's a great tackle at the 31.
Carson makes the tackle at the 31-yard line. That makes it 4th and 4.
Davidson is the punter. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Gets it out quickly. And he's level at the 45-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Look at the strength. He gets hit out of bounds.
At about the 37-yard line.
That brings up 2nd and 1.
Here's the halfback. Nice run to the left there. Bowling Green's going to use their first time out of the half here. From the 33-yard line, 1st down. Runs right for a nice game. The Falcons call a timeout. That's their 2nd of the half. Inside the 10. Touchdown. Big play. Big time touchdown on the ground for what looks to be the score that puts this one on ice. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
So we're just about ready to return to action.
And he throws it away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Just under 2 minutes in the game. Throws out to the back, and who can't hold on to it?
Number 28, the intended receiver on the play.
From their own 25-yard line, third down. Wants to go long and does. Great catch, and he's out of bounds.
Hit and taken down.
First down.
Here's a quick throw. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it.
This just shows you that you don't need to be sacking the quarterback to disrupt the passing game.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line. He fires left side, throws, and he's got a man. Touchdown. And for Lewis, he racks up more yardage, and that brings his receiving total to 100.
Even when he isn't open, the quarterback will still throw him the ball and just let him make a play. It really shows the trust that the quarterback has with his receiver.
So the offense will stay on the field and attempt the two-point conversion. A nice six-play, 75-yard drive. But the failed two-point conversion keeps it a six-point score.
And, Brad, you're going to move the ball at will when you're able to execute the pass game like that. Those big plays eventually are going to lead you to touchdowns.
And he's hammered down. The Eagles are on a roll right now, an absolute roll. 21 straight points, and the defense has no answer for them. So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. And down he goes around the 32-yard line. The Falcons using their third and final timeout. It's first and 10. Ball on the 32-yard line. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Decent run up the gut. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. And the ball game's over. And our final score in this one, 42-26.
42. And the Falcons. 26.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.